Hello, class. My name is Brian Layton, and this is my class to the state legislature, and it is for prison reform for the mentally ill. So, when you look at the statistics, it's pretty alarming. We have a lot of folks in our prisons that have mental illness, some of them severe mental illness. According to the American Psychiatric Association, we have a lot of folks with major psychiatric disorders in our prisons right now, and they're in need of care. So it's a proven fact that mistreatment is occurring in our prisons, and it's happening today on a daily basis. Please watch the following video.
Sonoma County sued after jail staff tases mentally ill shoplifter to death. Sonoma County, Washington is being sued by the family of a mentally ill man who was arrested for shoplifting and had a heart attack due to unnecessary violence by the prison staff. On the evening of his death, Bill Williams, an Everett resident with physical and mental problems, stole a pack of cigarettes and a lighter from a convenience store. Soon after, he returned to the shop to steal a six-pack of beer. The total value of the stolen items was less than $15. Police were called after the second theft. Officers arrived at the scene and found Williams walking nearby and arrested him. He wasn't cooperative, and after a struggle, the officers brought him to Sonoma County Jail. According to the lawsuit, Williams had cuts on his wrist and right hand, and his face was badly bruised. He was also on antipsychotic medication. When told to change into a jail uniform, he advanced on a corrections officer and was pinned to the ground by five or six people while the sergeant in charge shocked him with a taser. Williams went limp and stopped breathing, and his skin turned noticeably blue. When he regained consciousness, he swore at a corrections officer. In return, the sergeant in charge of booking told her colleagues to put him on his feet. They then forced him into a holding cell and knelt on his shoulders, neck, and back. The sergeant shocked Williams again with a taser, this time firing its metal darts into his side. He was left face down in the prison cell, his hands cuffed behind his back. Only sometime later, the sergeant realized he wasn't breathing. He was pulled from the cell. Jail staff and Everett Fire Department medics tried to revive him, unsuccessfully. The autopsy showed that he'd suffered injuries to his head, ribs, and wrists. His heart attack was also caused by the altercation. A year after Williams died, an investigation found that Sonoma County Jail was inadequately staffed, too crowded, and unable to ensure that mentally fragile inmates were properly treated.
Okay, so how did we get here? During the 1960s, the states got together and they decided that it was time to close the state mental health facilities and move those mentally ill folks into the community. And they did it with the best intentions. It was so that the mentally ill could live more independent lives and become part of their communities. But as deinstitutionalization occurred, the feds nor the states reappropriated money for the local community services boards to deal with the influx of the mentally ill folks that came into the communities. And this turned our local jails and prisons into America's major mental health facilities, a purpose for which they were not intended. So how do we fix the problem? First, we gotta know the statistics. We have to acknowledge that there is abuse that is occurring. We have to train our personnel properly. We have to fund our facilities, and we have to find the proper leadership. The following graph shows you the statistics, and they're pretty alarming. So in training, training is paramount. There are excellent training programs out there to include CIT, crisis intervention training, that's done at the local law enforcement level as well as in the 911 center, and I recommend it for our jails. CIT does several things for the community and for the mentally ill. One is it brings awareness and education. It builds trust, and it ultimately gets folks, mental health folks, the services that they need so they can live better lives and stay out of our institutions. So in closing, we have to recognize there is a problem. The mentally ill will continue to be incarcerated. Training and education is needed. Mandatory use of force reporting is something that we absolutely need to do, and I suggest that, that it's tracked at the FBI, just like our UCR crime stats are. Abuse cannot be tolerated. Additional funding from the states and federal system is absolutely needed. And implementing CIT resources in our community and our prisons could help with the problem. Here are my resources, and thank you for watching my presentation.